A lot of people want to create automatic documents from their Airtable data, but there is not a native solution that always solves this problem because Page Designer, the app that's inside of Airtable, leaves a little bit to be desired. Well, I am happy to report that it is now possible thanks to a software that, yes, while their paid version is probably something that you'll fall in love with and want to start spending money with them, their free version is really good as well. So if you're interested in learning how to create automated documents from Airtable data, this is the video for you. Let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I am Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and I'm gonna help you save up to 20 hours per week thanks to automation and no-code tools. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about that, because let's be honest, who doesn't want to get more time back? Check the link below. And once you're all signed up there, you will get access to my workshop that will teach you the basic fundamental building blocks of automation so that you too can start saving 20 hours per week. But without further ado, let's hop into the actual heart of this video. We've got to talk about automatic document generation. First and foremost, as you probably know if you've watched videos here before, we have to start with data structure. So I'm going to hop into my Airtable and explain or outline the overall table that we've built. Pretty straightforward. I've got company, that's table number one. Here I've got a name, an address, a logo, and that links to my invoice. Now the goal here is to create an invoice. So on my invoices table, I have an invoice. This is just a formula. It's looking at my auto number, which is just going to continually tick one by one as records are added, and it's making that a four-digit invoice, so 1,000+ auto number. As I mentioned earlier, I'm linked to my company, and then a part that a lot of people tend to miss is line items. So if you're struggling to put together an invoice that includes line items, you're going to really love this as well. I also have notes here, and this is the note on the actual invoice itself. I'm able to look up a subtotal, determine if I need tax. I have a formula calculating to write in my tax amount. In my case, I'm doing 4% of the subtotal if it requires tax. And then, of course, I'm also able to build a formula that calculates my grand total. And then we have a review process internally. So somebody has to check that box that says, yep, it's time to review and produce this thing. Now, I'm also storing my automated document here. Here's a version of what one of those looks like. Now this one has been completed already, but we're going to go into how it got created. So this is automatically uploaded back here to the field called hard copy. And then I have company table ID and line item table ID. This is critical for how we're going to build the automated process that's going to create this document for us. Because actually when I do that document creation, it has to go a layer deep. It has to know information about the company. The address of the client, the name of the client, and the logo of the client. It's going to get that information by referencing the table. And so in order to grab this table ID, here I've already pre-written my formula, but I want to flip back into my company table, and up in my URL, if I'm using the browser, the table ID is a random string of text that is unique for this table, and it's found inside here, inside of the two slashes, and it always starts with TBL. So grab that value, copy it, go back to your invoices table and just paste that in inside of quotation marks into a formula field. Similarly, we're going to do the same thing for line items. Grab that table ID once we're in the line item table and paste it back here. Now line items, a layer deeper here, we have a name for the line item, the price, the quantity, and of course a calculated amount. Price times quantity, pretty straightforward formula here. Lastly, we have the invoices. So every single line item is linking back to an invoice as well. This is an important element of getting your invoices correct because a lot of times people will fail to put in the line items in the right way and they're unable to charge for multiple things on the same invoice, which kind of defeats the purpose of creating an invoice. All right, so we've got the structure in place. Let's jump into Documint. Now, Documint is the tool that I recommend for automated document creation because it was built specifically to serve Airtable. So it is the perfect automated document creation tool as it pertains to people inside of the Airtable ecosystem. Inside of Documint, the big thing to know is that there is design and preview. Now, I'm working with a template here. So just to back up a little bit, when you start with Documint, you're going to be asked to create a template or to start from scratch. I went ahead and selected the invoice template when I got started. So it exists right here. You can start working with that and it's going to streamline a lot of your workflow. But if you want to, of course, you can create your own blank template as well. Now, once you're inside of the actual document itself, I've gone ahead and made sure that I mapped to all the different things in Airtable. And these different variables have to match exactly how I've named my fields in Airtable. Another thing to note is that there's a lot that you can do in terms of how you format the output that Document does when it creates the document itself. In this case, this is some currency formatting or rich text formatting. It's too much for me to go into all of that here in this video, but just know that there's a lot of formatting options available to you. The fun part that I want to show you here is how to automatically create that document as soon as you are ready to go. And Document has made this so super easy. All you have to do in the upper right corner, click Integrations, click on Airtable, and we're going to go and grab that table URL again. And Document is actually going to create a script for us that's going to allow us to automatically create this document without needing any kind of external integration or automation. We're not going to need Zapier. We're not going to need Integromat. This is going to occur directly inside of Airtable automations. So let's grab that table URL, go back to Airtable, make sure we're in the invoices table, copy this URL, and paste it back into Document right there in the builder. Now, don't skip on the options. I made this mistake once and it cost me because we need to make sure we tell it where we want to store that document when it's created. Let's go in here. This gets stored in hard copy. So copy the name of that field, paste it back here. We're going to overwrite attachments, meaning if there's already something there, we want to overwrite it. I'm going to go a layer deep. My invoices has a lot of the information, but company has informations as well. Or the linked line items have information as well. So I need to go a layer deep when I'm searching for that. And that's why we built those table IDs so that Document can use all that information in generating our document. Now, in terms of this, I need to select active. Even though my template is currently inactive, I need to overwrite that for this particular automation and generate an actual active document. And down here, I can tell Document to watch certain paths and it will create a document again if certain paths are changed or ignore certain paths as well. The cool part is this entire script is automatically created for us. So again, I'm going to copy this to my clipboard, pop back into Airtable, and I'm going to set up an automation. Now, in this particular case, I set up a trigger that says, hey, I want a box to be checked and I want hard copy to be empty, meaning that I don't already have a document stored in this particular record. And then I add the run a script action. All I have to do is paste that script in here, the one I just copied from Document. It did all the heavy lifting for us. The only extra part that we need to do is make sure to name a parameter of record ID. In order to do this, we already established that variable, record underscore ID. That came through from the script Document created. So we just need to add an input variable and make sure that we link it up to the record ID that we identified in the trigger of this automation. Once we're all set with that, we can go ahead and test this whole thing out. Make sure to turn your automation on, give it a name, and let's back up and set up a new document to be generated. So here I am. You see my invoice is automatically populated with the number. I choose the client receiving this invoice and grab that. Now let's set up some line items. I'm going to go ahead and fast forward while I do that. All right, so now I've created three different line items, and to keep things simple, I'm keeping the price at 101 for line item 1, 200 and quantity 2 for line item 2, etc. Now we can leave in some notes, and as I mentioned earlier, we can even include that rich text. So let's go with some notes. Now we have to make a determination on tax. I'll say no, and ideally once then the checked boxes marked for having been reviewed, the automation will kick in. It's working in the background right now. We haven't used Integromat or Zapier, but we see that something was just uploaded to the site. We can go ahead and pop in to take a look at that document. And there we go. All the line items, all the subtotal and the grand total, all the information that lives at the company level as well. And in this particular case, I'm even including the company logo. Now, you probably wouldn't do this for an actual invoice. You'd put your own company logo, not the client company logo. But just to showcase this, I will delete that. I will uncheck the box And let's say we changed the client because there was an error, and actually this invoice was needed to be sent to Document. I'll check that box again, my automation will re-trigger, and we just have to sit back for a moment or two, wait for that document to get uploaded, and we can pop in now to see that the Document logo has been added to this one instead of the Gap logo. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If you did and you intend to start using Document, please consider using the affiliate link below in the description of this video. It will be a nice way for you to show some love and support to the channel, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.